The Disaster and Preparedness Minister, Hilary Onek, officiated at the ceremony, which attracted different stakeholders, including ambassadors and Christine Hammondson, the ambassador of the Royal Norwegian Embassy, and Kevin Colgan, the ambassador of the Republic of Ireland in Uganda. Abdurrahman Megang, the World Food Programme Uganda country representative, explained the value of the self-reliance model. Under the self-reliance model, the World Food Programme aims to scale up such interventions to enable more people to earn a decent living from farming and other activities.
Those who want to work on non-agriculture, those who want to work on a non-farming project, you know, projects. So it's a variety of projects that will be under the self-reliance. But this cannot be done without the support of the government.
Uganda today currently hosts close to 1.6 million refugees. The project will be implemented in southwestern Uganda and West Nile, which have some of the oldest refugee settlements in the country, to support refugees and host communities.
From Isingiro, it will now go to all other refugee settlements that we are holding in Uganda, so that they all adapt the same that we have done in Isingiro today.
We are going to support the refugees and host communities by providing irrigation, hiring varieties, extension services.
The ambassadors hailed the tremendous generosity of Uganda to host millions of refugees and the progressive refugee policy, which they said is a model globally. They pledged their country's commitment to prioritize support and protection for refugees.
Uganda continues to be Africa's largest refugee hosting country. And I would like to use this opportunity to again commend Uganda for its generous and progressive refugee policy. It's a model for countries globally.
Moving across to the poor rabbits, I'm very sorry for the rabbits of the day. Minister, you'll see this all later. Moving across to people who are helping to train people and build people's capacity to participate in agriculture, to finally to the group of Somali refugees who are doing cosmetics and tie-dye.
The launched model is funded by the governments of Ireland and Norway to the tune of over $15 million, which will focus on promoting income generation among refugees, increase their access to social protection, support social norms change, and equip refugees with financial skills. At the launch, livelihood groups from the refugees and host communities were given tools to use to increase production. Story compiled by Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news.